So I'm going to get this out of the way just for people who are here to learn tips and tricks about how to make films. Never, ever forget the importance of the schedule and the script breakdown. I cannot tell you how many times I was stuck in this movie just with no props, no characters, no backgrounds that I really, really needed and were essential for the script. And it brought my whole animation process to a screeching halt. It was bad. Tip number two, don't try anything super duper fancy if you're going for your first short film. This is my first time using DaVinci Resolve, which, great program. You get to do all your editing and visual effects and color grading in one program instead of outsourcing it to like 50 with Adobe, which is wonderful. But it crashed for me. My GPU is not very good, so it was very frustrating. So now it's time for my behind the scenes story. I made the script in like 2 days because I knew it had to be simplistic and very, very easy to read. Because it's a film contest. It's not a script writing contest. You insane? I got it done in like a day. Second of all, I knew that there was something going on that may have made meeting large groups of people very, very difficult. Cult. So I opt for animation. Now seeing that 2D animation is very, very lengthy process and 3D animation can be finicky and I don't really know how to do it, I outsourced to one of my favorite techniques, which is stop motion. So something so basic that you probably learned it when you were doing photography in 6th grade. To create the characters, I sketched all of them out on paper in advance just to see what they look like. And then I took all of those pictures and like cut them out into individual joints and stuff I would later use in Photoshop. I uploaded all the cutting out parts to my mom's magic cutting machine, and it cut it out for me. I was very proud of that. Then I glued it all together, used bobby pins to create all the joints. There's this trick online that says that you should use wire, but I didn't really know how to do that, and like I said, gotta stick to the stuff that you know. To create the audio, I use the RODE VideoMic Go. Its shock mount is amazing. The cable's detachable, so I could easily plug in a TRRS phone in here and connected directly to my phone, which is my camera of choice. And I plan on using this in further projects along with this windscreen and the boom pole that I also purchased it with. As much as I would have loved to make the background in real life, I wouldn't know how large the characters would be in comparison to like a printed sheet of paper. For the backgrounds, I outsourced to my good friend Gabe, who is an artist and a lot better than me at most things, so if the backgrounds look unusually great, that's why.